Are you coming off the clouds yet?
Yes.
What do you see down there below you?
Look around you.
Seems like trees.
Seems like trees.
It's dark.
It's dark. Tell me more. What's the first impression that you have?
It's a little boy.
A little boy. Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
Looks like it's me.
Mm-hmm. Look down at your feet. Tell me what you're wearing.
Nothing.
Mm-hmm. You barefooted?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
I don't know.
Do you feel older or younger than 10?
Older.
Mm-hmm. Older or younger than 15?
Older.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel?
I'm not the boy. Mm-hmm. I am the boy, but I'm not the boy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm also a man.
Mm-hmm. So tell me more about that. You see yourself as a little boy, but you're someone else?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So describe yourself to me. Which one would you like to describe?
Some type of warrior.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, some type of warrior.
Okay. So describe what you're wearing.
Leopard skin.
Mm-hmm. Leopard skin.
Do you have anything on your feet?
No.
Mm-hmm.
Feathers.
Feathers. Where are the feathers?
My ankle.
Okay. Feathers on your ankle?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I have a spear in my hand.
A spear?
Mm-hmm. Can you describe your features?
Very strong.
Very strong features?
Mm-hmm. Dark. Muscular. Slim.
Mm-hmm. What's your hair look like?
I don't think I have hair.
Hmm.
It's just probably short or bald or something.
Mm-hmm. So tell me what you're doing there. Look around you.
Standing there with the little boy.
Mm-hmm. What is your role? What role do you play with him?
I think I'm the father.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
He's looking up at me.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like I'm teaching him something.
So let's just follow the scene and tell me what happens.
I'm walking with him.
Mm-hmm.
I'm teaching them. There's a woman coming, approaching.
Mm-hmm. What does she look like?
Very beautiful.
Mm-hmm. How would you describe her? What's she wearing?
Just a skirt thing.
Mm-hmm.
Made out of some skin.
Mm-hmm. Is it similar to yours?
Almost.
Mm-hmm. Who is this woman?
Maybe she's my wife.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So tell me everything that happens. The more detail you say, the more you'll see.
She's hugging me.
Mm-hmm. She's hugging me?
She's holding the child.
Mm-hmm.
And now we're walking back home.
Mm-hmm.
walking back home.
So let's get to your home and see where it is.
There's a lot of people.
Mm-hmm. Describe
where you are.
I'm in a village.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people in this village.
Mm-hmm. What kind of dwellings are there?
Kind of like a hut.
Mm-hmm.
I'm somebody important to them. I think I'm their king.
Mm-hmm.
People come and give me things, gifts.
What are they giving you?
Coconuts. Food. My wife is annoyed. She wants me to come home.
Mm-hmm. Are you still walking?
Yeah, I got it. I'm inside this big hut.
Mm-hmm. Describe what it looks like inside.
It has a fireplace in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
With rocks. A lot of mats on the floor, different colors, red, blue, with designs on them.
Mm-hmm.
It looks bigger on the inside than it does on the outside.
The hut is bigger on the inside?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What else do you see inside this hut?
I see an elder smoking a pipe.
Mm-hmm. Who is he?
He's an old man. I think he's a good friend.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think this is my house. Because I'm not... I'm in there by myself. My wife is gone.
Mm-hmm.
These are the elders.
How many are there?
About four of them. Four or five of them.
Mm-hmm.
Or more. This is the place where we meet.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what happens.
I have to sit with them for something.
So connect with them and see what it is that you're discussing.
Supposed to give me lessons.
Mm-hmm. What kind of lessons?
Lessons for the tribe. To learn how to lead the tribe.
Mm-hmm.
They're putting something on, a crown on my head, and somebody's putting a crown on my head.
What's the crown made out of?
Something gold plated.
Mm-hmm.
Gold something. I feel honored.
Mm-hmm.
But I still feel like I don't know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
And they're telling me that I'm ready. That I'm the king.
Mm-hmm. Who was the king before you?
King died by some type of animal.
Mm-hmm. How did they select you?
I'm the son.
Mm. Were you trained by your father to be king?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I was preparing for this since I was 12.
Okay. And how old are you now?
30.
Mm-hmm. What do they call you?
Jamu.
Jamu? That's your name?
Warrior.
Warrior? Is that what Jamu means?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So tell me what happens next.
I'm bidding them farewell to go home. I'm humbled, and I want to tell my wife about it. I'm walking home. My house is small. It's like a teepee or something.
Mm-hmm. What's it made out of?
Cloth.
Cloth. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so the door is cloth. She has food for me. Somebody's at the table. I'm happy. Telling her the story of what happened with the elders. I meet with them frequently.
What else happens?
Just sitting down, mm-hmm. talking, eating, and looking around. Seeing the bed. Very humble home.
Do you see any more children there?
Yes.
How many children do you see?
There's a baby.
Mm-hmm. Is it a boy or a girl?
Girl.
Mm-hmm. Who else is there?
A little boy. Mm-hmm. My wife. Very nice.
Very nice. Look into those, into their eyes. Look into your children's eyes and see if you recognize them from anyone in this lifetime.
I get the impression that one of them is my sister.
Mm-hmm. Connect with it now. Connect with the child and see if it is.
Yeah, that's the impression I'm getting.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Very good. All right, so I want you to close that scene now. Close that scene behind you, and I'd like you now to drift and float to another important scene in that same lifetime. Close it behind you and tell me where you are.
I'm giving instruction to warriors.
Mm-hmm. How many are there?
There's a bunch of people. I'm giving instructions to one. There's a bunch of people mm-hmm. running around. So we're being attacked by something. Mm-hmm. Some other people.
Can you see the attackers?
Yeah, different tribe.
Mm-hmm. What do they look like?
Wearing paint, war paint. Mm-hmm. White. Green, white, almost like Indians or something. Huh? Mm-hmm.
Do you look different than they do?
No. But my skin is like their skin, like it's like dark red. Mm-hmm.
What happened?
I'm fighting this man.
What are you using to fight him?
He jumped on me, so I have this short knife. But he's gone.
Mm-hmm.
I'm running to go help my friends, my soldiers. Running real fast to go help my soldiers. Running through the woods, this battle in the woods. Tall, big trees, big, huge, tall trees.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more. What happened?
The bloody scene. I mean, seeing where a lot of people got killed.
How are you feeling?
I'm kneeling next to someone that I know. He reminds me of my son.
Mm-hmm.
I'm crying. But I'm upset.
Mm-hmm. Who is this man?
A friend.
Mm-hmm.
I have to pee now.
Be there now. You're back in that scene.
Yes.
Tell me what's happening.
Still holding my friend.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want to leave him there.
Is he alive or is he gone?
He's not alive.
Mm-hmm.
He has a hole in his chest.
Mm-hmm. What happened to him?
Someone stabbed him with something.
Mm-hmm. I want you to connect with your emotions and tell me what you're feeling.
Like, I don't want this to be happening.
Mm-hmm.
It hurts me in my heart.
Do you feel responsible for this?
I feel I should have been there.
Mm-hmm.
Which would have never happened. I got taken back.
All right, so tell me what happens as you take him back home.
I'm carrying him back home.
Are you by yourself?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
There's noise in the background.
There's noise in the background? What do you hear?
Yelling.
Mm-hmm.
Screaming.
What's happening?
People fighting.
Is this the... Are these the warriors that are fighting?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They're chasing people away.
Mm-hmm.
My fight is done.
Your fight is done.
I have to take him home.
Mm-hmm. Who was this man to you?
He reminds me of my son.
Mm-hmm.
It's like my son. He's my friend.
Mm-hmm.
I'm walking by the village people. I don't want no one to touch him.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take care of it.
What do you do?
Sitting down, his wife wants the body. But I can't believe this is happening. I should have been there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm supposed to protect my people.
You're supposed to protect your people. Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna go and kill all of them.
You're gonna go kill all of them? Alright, so tell me what happens next.
I'm getting ready for battle.
Mm-hmm. What are you doing?
My wife is telling me not to go. I'm not going to bring him back. I'm on horses now.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to get him.
How many of there are you?
Hundreds.
Mm-hmm.
Like I'm some type of Indian.
Mm-hmm.
My skin is red. Like, unbelievably red.
Mm-hmm.
Like an Indian. Making sounds like an Indian.
Mm-hmm.
I'm on a white horse.
Are you wearing anything special for this battle?
War paint.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, war paint, feathers. Yeah, the whole thing. The whole feather on my head.
Mm-hmm. How many feathers do you have? A lot?
A lot. They're long.
Mm-hmm. What is the significance of the feathers?
I'm the chief.
Mm-hmm.
And also the warrior. One of the top warriors. I'm angry. I'm burning huts or something.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people are dying. For some reason, the men are not there yet.
Mm-hmm.
But I ordered the slaughter of the whole village. I'm gonna wipe everyone out.
Tell me more.
The whole village is burning. I'm in a lot of blood and I have blood on me.
Who have you killed?
A lot of people, women, children, everybody. Cattle, everything. Their men are standing up in the horizon and I'm staring at them. They come back. And I'm waiting to engage. They're coming. And I'm running towards them on foot. They're on horses. I'm stronger. I'm not a regular person. I can take a blow from a horse. They're stronger too. They're vicious people trying to bite me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm killing them with a sword, with my spear. Fights. We have shields.
What are these shields made out of?
Animal skin.
Mm-hmm. They protect you?
Yeah, the shields are crashing. It's a lot of yelling, a lot of killing. A lot of blood, a lot of guts. A lot of Indian hollering. Yeah, that's what that was. Mm-hmm. I think I'm in India. I got the chief.
How did you get him?
From his horse. I got him. He's dead. That's it.
Okay. Anything else from that scene that's important? Look around you.
The men are cheering.
Your men?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking at the carnage.
How does that make you feel?
Too much death. Too much death.
What emotions are you feeling? Feel them in your body.
Guilt. Shame.
All right. So close that scene now. Close that scene, and now we're going to go forward to another important day in that same lifetime. Move forward. Where are you?
I'm outside with my wife talking.
Mm-hmm.
I like to talk to her.
What are you talking about?
The family.
What's going on?
I'm just looking at how big these trees are and how peaceful it is.
Mm-hmm.
People carrying food and day-to-day village stuff.
Mm-hmm.
The women are darker. They look more African.
Mm-hmm. Look at their features.
Yeah, it's more African, more very feminine built, but very strong women.
Mm-hmm.
They're carrying stuff on their heads. They have no clothes on, except the little thing around the waist.
Mm-hmm.
Babies don't have any clothes on.
Mm-hmm. What are you wearing?
Wearing a leopard thing over me.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a short spear. Playing with my wife. She's the enemy and I'm fighting against her. We're playing.
Mm-hmm.
And my son is watching, laughing.
How old is your son now?
1 year.
Mm-hmm.
Probably another child or something.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's a little boy laughing.
How do you feel there?
I feel happy.
Mm-hmm. Look around and see if there's anything important from this scene. that you can take from it?
My family.
Mm-hmm.
I have a family.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Let's close that scene now. Let's move forward to another important day in that same lifetime. Move forward now and tell me where you are.
Just sitting down in this room in the dark.
Where is this room?
I don't know, it's like a dark chamber. I'm just sitting there in a seat,
mm-hmm.
thinking. I'm just sitting there thinking by myself, I guess meditating or something.
Mm-hmm. Is this chamber for that purpose?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
My ancestors.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is where they come to meet me.
Okay. So let's see what happens as the ancestors come.
Yeah, they're there.
Describe them.
Old women.
Mm-hmm.
Young women. Older women, my aunt, one of my aunts is there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they're there.
Mm-hmm. So what do they have to say?
They're telling me how proud they are of me.
Mm-hmm. What else?
How that they're with me.
Mm-hmm.
They're there to help me. That they see me.
Mm-hmm.
Even when I can't see them. They're touching my hair. My aunt touching my hair.
Mm-hmm.
Telling me how much she loves me. But they're not talking. This is mental.
Mm-hmm. Tell me everything they say.
I love you. I'm translating.
Mm-hmm. What is your aunt's
name? That you're a good man.
Mm-hmm.
Clara.
Clara, mm-hmm. What else?
She's telling me to be careful.
Mm-hmm.
Of the women that I bring into my life. It's dangerous. She's talking about the images.
Mm-hmm.
That she warned me before. I remember.
What is she warning you of?
The images.
Mm-hmm. What are these images?
Women.
Mm-hmm.
Not to indulge in these things.
Mm-hmm.
That I have a wife. That's all I need.
Mm-hmm.
She's reprimanding me so much I can't hardly understand what she's saying.
Mm-hmm. Tell her to slow down.
Says I'm hard-headed. I let things take me further. I know that I shouldn't let things... I know that I get addicted to things fast. I shouldn't indulge in things that I know that I could get addicted to. She warns me not to do it. It's just not going to be good for me if I keep doing stuff like that. Mm-hmm. She's always been like that.
Ask Aunt Clara if there's anybody influencing you.
She said, yes, my mom. Mm-hmm. I asked her what. She said, how? I said, how? She said, I need to ask her. Mm-hmm. That I know how she is. That she's mean like that. Mm-hmm. Stop talking. Mm-hmm.
Ask her if she recommends that we connect with your mom.
Says no. Mm-hmm. Doesn't want me to connect with that. Mm-hmm. She says she's protecting me.
Mm-hmm. Who else is protecting you? Ask her.
Yava. Mm-hmm. Bookman.
Bookman? Legba and Bookman? Would they be able to help us today?
Just Bookman.
Bookman.
Some other people, I don't know their names. Mm-hmm.
Would Bookman be able to assist me today?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can I speak with this Bookman?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Tell me when he's there.
Okay.
Hello, Bookman.
Yes.
Thank you for coming here today. May I ask you some questions?
Yes.
How is it that you help this man?
Gives me strength.
Mm-hmm. Tell me how you give him strength.
To read?
Mm-hmm.
To be interested in books.
Mm-hmm. What kind of books?
Books for self-knowledge.
Mm-hmm. You're the one who's leading him to that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What would you like him to eventually do with all of this wisdom?
To help his people. Mm-hmm. He needs to understand that he needs to help his people.
In what way?
He needs to tell them who they are.
Mm-hmm. All of the experiences that he's been going through, Bookman, has that been to help?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
He knows that.
Mm-hmm.
He knows that we're with him.
Mm-hmm. How many of you are there that work with him?
Hundreds.
Hundreds.
He has a whole family.
Mm-hmm. Who's the main one?
Pierre.
Pierre. Is that an ancestor?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who is he?
He's my friend.
He's your friend. Are you an ancestor too, Bookman?
No.
No? Did you ever know this man in a different life?
Yes.
Who was he to you?
He was my friend.
Mm-hmm. Is he the one, are you the one that got killed?
No.
No? That's somebody else?
Yes.
Is he your friend from another lifetime or from the spirit realm?
From the spirit.
Okay. Are you his guide?
Yes.
Okay, good. Are you his primary spirit guide, then?
One of them.
One of them. You say he has hundreds of them.
Yes.
That help him. Okay. Can you tell me more about his life, Bhagwan? Why did you bring him here today?
He has to understand that he has us.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't want to believe. He thinks he's making it up in his mind.
Mm-hmm.
But he needs to understand that he's helping us.
How is he helping you?
He gives us strength whenever he prays.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever he does the work. He needs to do the work.
And what is the work?
The work is the things that he's doing, the candles,
mm-hmm.
the flowers, the things that he thinks about that we need.
Mm-hmm. The ancestors?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
We need those things.
What is going on with you that you need all of that?
I need to elevate.
Mm-hmm.
I need to get to a place where I can help him,
mm-hmm.
help me, to help the family.
Mm-hmm.
The family has sunken down to a low level. And we need to bring the family back up. He knows that.
Mm-hmm. Bookman, is there anything that I can help you with today?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Tell me how I can help you.
Help him to believe.
Okay.
That we're here.
Mm-hmm. Bookman, are you residing in his body?
No.
No? Do you reside in his dreams, in the astral world?
Yes.
Okay. Can you tell me a little bit about what happens to him when he dreams? Where does he go?
He goes to his other families.
Mm-hmm.
He thinks he only has one life. But he's living multiple lives.
Where are these lives?
Different worlds.
He always sees a lot of women. Who are they?
His wives, his ancestors, his friends, his sisters, his family.
Mm-hmm. Why just women? He seems to always see women and not that many men.
Because he likes women.
Okay. What else does he need to know about that?
He should listen.
Mm-hmm.
Study. Find out about the symbols. Meditate. Understand the language. That the language is different from what we speak here.
Mm-hmm.
Words are not sufficient.
What do you communicate with?
Mind.
Mm-hmm.
Even now, I'm using his mind to interpret what I'm saying to you,
mm-hmm.
because I don't speak English.
Mm-hmm.
And he's doing a good job interpreting what I'm saying.
Wonderful. But where is it that you come from originally? Are you from a different planet?
I don't think you would understand.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't think he understands for me to explain it
mm-hmm.
through him.
Is it like a different dimension?
Yes, like somewhere very far.
Mm-hmm. He had told me one time that about Sirius.
That's where he's from.
That's where not from where you are then.
No.
Okay. Okay. Bookman, is there anything else that you would like to say? Because I'd like to connect with his higher self.
He's a very powerful man.
Mm-hmm.
That's why he likes Superman.
Mm-hmm.
Because that's who he is. But he doesn't know it. He doesn't want to believe. He thinks it's a cartoon.
Mm-hmm.
If you could only get him to believe. he needs to believe.
In his power?
Then again, he needs to know. He needs to know who he is.
Mm-hmm.
And we're trying to build him.
How do you build him?
By studying his ancestors. For a long time, he thought that he was incapable of certain knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
But we're here to tell him that he's more than capable. He's already has the knowledge. He's remembering.
Mm-hmm.
He don't have to learn anything. He just has to remember.
Mm-hmm. Bookman, is there anything that I can do to help heal?
Is it the ancestors?
You're doing much.
Can I do more? Can we bring in the divine light?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So I'd like to bring that in.
Do what your wisdom tells you to do.
Mm-hmm. So I'd like to bring in the divine one, the divine light in. I'd like the divine light to encircle this man, this room. And I know that all of the ancestors are here with him. I'd like the divine light to come in and fill all of their souls. And as they fill with this beautiful light, expand it out from inside of them, heal their pain, so that they are one with the divine light. And as the light fills them, I want them to increase their vibration with love, because nothing can harm them when there's love. So as the divine light comes in, and I'm asking all of the ancestors to only focus on love and to heal from within as a collective. We want to heal their past lineage, the present lineage, and the future lineage. I want the vortex of the white light to just encircle him and all of the ancestors. And Bookman, as this happened, tell me what's going on with you.
This is good.
Mm-hmm.
We need this.
Increase that divine light. I want you to increase the vibration of the room with all of the ancestors here. Increase that light and that love from within. Keep filling it all with light. And Bookman, keep reporting back to me and tell me what's happening.
Everybody's happy.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody's cheering in different dialects.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what it feels like.
It feels warm.
Mm-hmm.
Very warm. Very powerful.
Mm-hmm. Focus on how it's changed you.
I feel lighter.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I could go home.
All right. So I'd like the divine light now to encircle all of you, the entire lineage. And just encircle you and bring you to home. Take you back so that you can now help all of your ancestors from the divine light yourself. Just report back to me and tell me what happens.
I don't want to leave him.
Well, Bookman, you won't be leaving him. You'll be with the light. You'll be able to help from there. You'll have more powers from there.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to tell him as you go?
Continue to read.
Mm-hmm.
Read a lot. Know your ancestors. Know who you are. Know that you are spirit.
Thank you, Bookman. May the light of the universe accompany you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And now I'd like to call in the higher self. May I speak with the higher self, please?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you for allowing this.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me why you showed him this life of a warrior? What did you want to tell him?
He needs to start acting like a warrior.
Mm-hmm.
He's taken a passive road through this life, and that's what's hurting him.
Mm-hmm.
That's why he gets into trouble.
Nothing.
That's why he's having the dreams about being in the back seat, not driving, because he's taking a passive role.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to take a more aggressive role. He needs to stand in his power.
What areas of his life is he lagging the most in?
Relationships.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to be the leader.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to lead the woman. They will trust him more. They get disappointed when he doesn't lead.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why they leave.
What caused him to act this way with women?
His mother.
Mm-hmm.
His mother abandoning him. He never forgot that.
Mm-hmm.
He used to cry daily for his mother.
Mm-hmm. And he's still holding that?
Not for him.
Mm-hmm.
But he's holding that because he's seen what it did to his brothers and sisters.
Mm-hmm.
He cares about them a lot.
Yeah. Would you be willing to answer the questions that he brought here today?
Yes.
Thank you. He wants to know why he was named the way he was.
The name of the ancient warriors.
Mm-hmm.
He knows that. He says that to people, but he thinks he's making it up.
Mm.
But it means success. It means great warrior. We have shown them this time and time.
Mm-hmm.
People see the warrior in him, but he doesn't see it in himself.
Okay. Now, when you say warrior, when you showed him that life, there was a lot of bloodshed, a lot of killing, a lot of shame and guilt. Is this a reason why he's not being a warrior now?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to get past that.
Would you allow me to do an exercise with him to release that?
Yes.
Okay, very good. So I'm going to ask now. And I'm going to put my hand on your chest. And as I do, I want you to go deep inside the life of that warrior. And I want you to give me all of those feelings that you felt, all of those emotions, that shame, that guilt, not being able to save your friend. Because of your emotions, many people were killed. Give them all to me. And tell me when you've taken them all out of every cell of your body.
Yes.
You take them all out and give them to the universe. Now in that space that's left, what would you like to put it with? Put in there?
Courage.
Let's put a lot of courage there, and I'm going to touch your forehead to seal it. What else would you like to put in there?
Love.
Mm-hmm. Let's put that in there. What else?
Decisiveness.
Mm-hmm. Very good. What else? Good.
Strength.
Mm-hmm. A lot of strength. Mm-hmm.
Compassion.
Put all that in there.
Gratitude.
Mm-hmm. You feel complete?
Yes.
Good. Very good. Let me speak with your higher self. How do you see him now?
Much better.
Much better. Very good. Is there a meaning that must be fulfilled?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell him about that?
He needs to stand up for his people.
Mm-hmm.
Especially the people of his own race. He has a part to play.
Mm-hmm.
But he's afraid.
Tell him what he needs to do.
He needs to speak to these young men.
Mm-hmm.
And tell them who they are. Because it's only through letting them know who they are.
Mm-hmm.
That they can understand. That this war will not be fought with guns and
mm-hmm.
killing. It's a mental war. And they need to understand that.
Mm-hmm. To make him strong.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Good. And he had experience of doing that as a warrior.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So he just needs to go back into that.
That's why he had the experience.
Mm-hmm. Good.
As a warrior, he can train other warriors.
Mm-hmm. Good. He's done it before.
Yes.
Can you tell him what the dreams are about being in school? He says he's been in high school twice, in college.
The dreams are about him being passive, not understanding that he's already gone through this, certain situations in his life. He doesn't have to worry about the outcomes. The outcomes will be the outcomes. They'll be fine. But when he goes back into high school, it's that he's repeating the same circumstances in his life, the same situations. And he's not understanding that he must grow in everything. In relationships, as a man, his career, everything that's happening to him is not by chance, but they are delicately orchestrated and scripted for him to win, to succeed, using his words.
Well, he seems to be doing that at work. But not with relationships.
He sabotages his relationships by the images that he watches.
Mm-hmm.
Every time he watches those images, he will sabotage the relationship. We would not permit him to continue in watching those type of images.
Mm-hmm.
He cannot be a warrior. He cannot come to his true kingship with that type of Achilles heels,
mm-hmm.
per se.
Yeah. Can you help him today, rewire him so that he's not tempted to see those images?
Yes.
Thank you. Let me know when you're done.
Okay.
Thank you. He wants to know who the mentors are that he has contracts with. He was asking about relationships in particular. Who does he have a contract with?
He definitely has a contract with Chantel, if that's what he's talking about. Mm-hmm. Even in the warrior, that's his wife.
Mm-hmm. So they've been together before.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And what role did he have to play in this one?
Well, he had to go in there to support, but instead of supporting and playing his role as a leader, he did not want to participate. He was angry.
Mm-hmm.
He refused to participate, even when we tried to guide him. He didn't want to listen. He did not participate in relationship. That's part of the school.
Mm.
He may have to go through it again.
Does he have to go with her again? Did he have a contract with her in particular?
Yes.
Okay.
That is his wife.
That is his wife. So you're telling him tonight that he's going to have to do what he came here to do with her?
He needs to accept that, that he needs to understand.
Mm-hmm.
That he needs to play the role of a leader.
Mm-hmm.
He may break the contract if he wants to. He has free will to do that.
Mm-hmm.
But he will go through it again. That's why he keeps meeting people with the same family structure.
Okay.
Because he has to learn how to be a leader in a family. That is very important.
Mm-hmm.
He's been always a leader in a family. And that's what we need to teach him again.
Okay. Who's going to help him with that?
I will help him.
Thank you. Good. He says that he's been thinking of a book about elephants.
Sifu.
Sifu. Mm-hmm.
I gave him that idea.
Mm-hmm.
He should write the book and stop procrastinating.
Will the information be downloaded to him?
Information has been downloaded to him many a times. Mm-hmm. He has ignored it.
What's he afraid of?
Failure.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a perfectionist.
Mm-hmm.
If he doesn't see the whole book, he thinks he doesn't have a book. But he does. He needs to stop procrastinating and write the book.
Okay, good. As far as the images that he was looking at, is there some sort of attachment to him that is influencing him? Can you take a look?
Yes.
Where is this attachment?
Somewhere in his feet.
In his feet? Okay. Would you allow me to address this entity today, and then we'll get back to you?
Yes.
Okay, great. So I'm going to go back down to his feet, and I'm going to use my energy to bring it up. We're bringing the energy up, 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 up. All the way up. Good evening. You can now express yourself.
Hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What may I call you? Are you
call me anything you want.
Ah, okay. Are you male or female?
Male.
Male. Okay. I'd like to help you today.
You can't help me.
I can't help you. Why not?
I don't need your help.
Oh, okay. Well, I'd like to get to know you a little bit. Can you tell me how long you've been with this man?
Years.
Years. How old was he when you found him?
8.
8 years old. What was going on in his life at that time that allowed you to attach to him?
He was sad.
He was sad. Mm-hmm. What was going on?
His father was beating him.
Mm-hmm. And how did you come across him? Were you in the same situation at one time?
I just saw him sitting in the dark room one day.
Uh-huh. Did he call for you?
No. He seemed to need a friend.
He needed a friend. Okay. Can you tell me how old you are? Are you his age too?
No.
How old are you?
I'm about 30.
30. Mm-hmm. And let me ask you something. How is it that you lost your body?
Accident.
What kind of accident?
Car accident.
Car accident. Were you driving?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So what happened?
I crashed. My family died.
Oh, that's so sad. How many of there were you?
Three of us.
Three of you.
He reminds me of my son.
Mm-hmm. How old was your son?
8.
8. So were you looking for your son?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But you found him instead?
Yes.
What happened to your family?
I don't know.
Do you think that they possibly went home to the light?
I don't know.
Hmm. But you didn't find your way home, did you?
No.
No. So you've been with him all this time. What have you caused him?
Helped him walk out.
Mm-hmm. Walk out of what?
Anything that he doesn't like. That's why he walks away from situations.
Do you think that helps him?
Yes.
It does. Mm-hmm. What else have you been doing for him?
I tempt him to go places.
Like where?
Places that he doesn't like to go.
And why is that?
Because he's afraid that he gets addicted to things.
Mm-hmm. Were you addicted to these things?
Yes.
Okay, so you kind of missed them yourself, didn't you?
Yes.
What kind of places did you go to?
Porn shops.
Mm-hmm.
Clubs, strip clubs.
Mm-hmm.
Parties.
Mm-hmm. You kind of missed that, didn't you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And you can't do it on your own as a spirit, can you?
No.
You use him instead.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And what did they call you when you were alive?
Mac.
So, Mac, what satisfaction do you get using him?
I get horny.
Uh-huh. But you don't have a body, do you?
No, well, he does.
He does. So you're using his body.
Yeah.
Mac, do you know that every being has free will?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So do you realize that you're violating his free will?
No.
Well, you are. You're using him. Do you realize that?
He doesn't mind.
He doesn't mind. Well, he has a job to do. He's got a very important mission. We've been speaking with his higher self.
You should go away.
I'm here to help you, Mac.
No, you're not.
Mac, every soul, when they die, needs to evolve. You should have gone with your family.
Hmm. Where's my family?
Your family should be in the light. But you remained here. You don't even have your own body. And when you go to the light, you'll be able to see your family again. You'll be welcomed home, your real home. You'll be able to go to school and come back and have your own life again.
Is this light real?
And you want to check it out for me? Let's try it. You willing to try?
Yes.
Okay. So, Mac, I just want you to look. I don't want you to stay, all right? Because I know what it's like for you to be tempted. I want you to come out through the crown of his head right here. And I'm going to have you encircled with all of my angels that help. They're going to come and take you to the light. And I want you to just look. Just go to the light and just take a look and see what's there. I don't want you to go there yet, though.
Hmm.
How does it feel?
I see something.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to ask for the angels of the light to help you. I'm going to have them escort you and surround you so that you can feel their love.
Okay.
And tell me what you feel.
Okay.
It feels good, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Would you like that to be permanent?
Yes.
Okay. But you can't go yet, Mac. We've got some work to do, okay?
Okay.
Mac, before you go, I know that you suffered after you died because you weren't able to find your little boy, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And you've had all those feelings bottled up inside of you.
Yes.
I'm going to put my hand on your chest. And when I do, I want you to give me all of those feelings. The pain of losing your son. The pain of not having your own body. Having to use somebody else to give you satisfaction, physical satisfaction, which we were longing for, spiritual satisfaction. Give me all of that to me. Give me all those emotions that you were feeling.
Okay.
I want to take them from you, Mac, and give them to the universe. And when you go to the light, you need to be very light and have all of those feelings, those wonderful feelings. Raise your vibration. What would you like to fill that space with now?
Love.
Let's fill it with love. Lots of love. And just seal that. What else?
Truth.
Lots of truth. Beautiful. What else?
Honor.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Anything else?
Purity.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. What else, Mac? Is that good?
Faithfulness.
Mm-hmm. Very good.
That's all.
Good. So, Mac, what I would like for you to do now, starting all the way from his feet, all the way up to his crown of his head, I want you to pull all of those cords that you attached to him. Cut them from your end too. Pull them out by the roots and, Mac, take them all out. All of those black cords. Everything that you influenced him. Pull them all out and tell me what they look like.
Black.
Mm-hmm.
Slime.
Mm-hmm. Pull it all out. Vacuum it out. Pull it out. Don't leave anything there. And tell me when you're done. Pull everything out.
Okay.
All right. So, Mac, I'd like you now to go out through the crown of his head again. I want the angels of the light to accompany you and take all of those cords with you and tell me when you get to the light and tell me who you see there.
See my wife and child.
Wonderful. Give him a big hug.
Yes.
Wonderful. Thank you, Mac, for allowing me to help you today to send you home. May the light of the universe accompany you. And is there anything that you would like to say to Glassman before you go?
Sorry.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Is there anything that Glassman would like to say before he goes?
Thank you.
Okay, very good. So I'd like my Archangel Gabriel to come in, and I'd like for you to seal all of the areas that were covered with that black slime and cords. Cover him completely with your light. And just report back to me and tell me what's happening.
Body is full of white light.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. Let me speak with the higher self again.
Yes.
Thank you very much for allowing that. How do you see him now?
He's good.
Very good.
Very clear.
Very clear. Very good. So that was a very strong influence that he had since he was 8 years old.
Yes, I feel much better.
Mm-hmm. Good, good. Would you tell him how old his soul is?
It's millions of years old.
Mm-hmm. Billions.
Millions.
Millions, uh-huh. Has he had a lot of lives?
Yes, but just not all of them on Earth.
Mm-hmm. Where else is he?
Other planets, other dimensions.
Mm-hmm. He wanted to know what star system he's from. Is that Sirius?
Sirius is a planet,
mm-hmm.
but sometimes humans confuse it
mm-hmm.
with star system, but they call it the star system Sirius.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess you can't call it that because there's multiple Sirius planets which consist of that system.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good.
Your body needs to relieve itself, no?
His body needs to relieve itself?
Yes.
Okay, all right. We're going to do the same thing that we did before. Two and one. Be there now.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Can we continue with the end, with the questions?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. He wanted to remove any attachments in his DNA and repair his DNA completely. Are there any attachments in his DNA?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell him about that?
Because he abused his body, there are certain attachments that we can remove.
Mm-hmm.
We can try to repair it. But he also has to understand that the Earth is going through its own DNA repair.
Mm-hmm.
And that he will eventually evolve with the Earth.
Mm-hmm. Is he feeling anything physically as the Earth changes?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
He has headaches.
Mm-hmm.
Pains in his arm, throbbing in his arms and legs.
Mm-hmm.
That's because of the shift.
The shift, okay, because he was asking about the migraines.
The migraines is because of the food that he's eating.
Ah.
Whenever he eats any too many foods with sugar or any type of starch, they turn to sugar in his body and they trigger these headaches.
So what would you recommend?
Recommend that when he eats, that he eats in smaller quantities.
Mm-hmm.
He can continue to eat what he eats, but just in smaller quantities. He doesn't have to be afraid to eat meat.
Okay, good. Good. So, would you remove the attachments that we were talking about in his DNA?
Yes.
Okay. And did those attachments have anything to do with the exercise that we did before in raising the vibration of his ancestors?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
His ancestors did many horrible things.
Mm-hmm.
And some of them were coming to him for healing.
Mm-hmm.
And he needs to understand that.
Mm-hmm.
That's why he's so bent on the ancestors, because they need him.
Mm-hmm.
He's the only one in a family that remembers them.
Mm-hmm. So did this exercise take them all home to the light?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So does he need to continue praying for them? Or will they be able to help him now?
No, they'll be able to help him.
Okay, perfect, perfect. Could you work on his brain so that it'll work faster, so he could learn faster and understand faster?
He's a very funny man.
Tell him why.
He does some funny things. It just makes us happy mm-hmm. when we hear his type of request. Mm-hmm. He has many such requests. Mm-hmm. That's why we permit him to fly in his dreams.
Ah, the astral traveling?
Yes. Mm-hmm. We permit him to do that because he wanted to do it so bad. Mm-hmm. And we let him do it because we want him to show him that he can do it. Mm-hmm. He can do anything that he puts his mind to.
Including having his brain work faster?
Including having his brain work faster. Mm-hmm. And it does. But sometimes he can't keep up with it.
Ah.
And he remembers. He says that he doesn't, but he remembers. Because when he starts to have conversation, he notices that the memories come back from things that he's read years ago.
Mm-hmm. So he's reading it and just storing it somewhere, like a little squirrel stores its nuts.
Yes, I just need to make sure that he understands where he's storing it.
Okay. All right. So he just can't find where the nuts are stored.
He doesn't have a system.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to understand that his brain is like a filing system.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to systematically categorize things and put them in the right place, and he'll find them faster.
Perfect. So there's nothing wrong with his brain at all?
No.
Okay. Good. He had asked about the removing any sexual deviant codes from his DNA.
Now, that is an issue.
Mm-hmm. Where is that coming from?
That was coming from the being that left them.
Mac. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
So, are we complete with that?
Yes.
Perfect. Great. Thank you.
He must understand not to engage in such activities. Such activities can lead to consequences that he will not appreciate.
Okay. Good. He wants to cut the webs of iron cords from his life of past lives with sexual karma. Does he have that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Where is that coming from?
That's coming from his ancestors.
Mm-hmm.
There's been a lot of deviancy, especially in the realm of sex,
mm-hmm.
throughout his line. And I do understand that he wants to cut that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think a lot of that has been resolved.
Wonderful. Thank you. What about cleaning the karmic debt from all of his lives?
I think we have resolved that.
We have resolved that. Good. Is that from the exercise that we did?
Yes.
That was pretty powerful exercise.
Yes.
It practically knocked me off my seat.
Yes. He's mm-hmm. clear.
He's clear. Good. He has a question about the abortions that took place and if there's any karma from that.
He knows there is.
Mm-hmm. What can we do about that today? Can we connect with these children?
They seem to want to.
Okay. Would you allow that?
Yes.
Okay. So allow me to connect with one of the children who would like to represent both of them?
It's three of them.
It's three of them. Okay. So who would like to be a representative?
J. Jamie.
Jamie, okay. Hello, Jamie.
Yes.
Jamie, are you a boy or a girl?
Girl.
Girl. What would you like to tell your dad about what happened?
I still love him.
Mm-hmm.
He's a good dad.
Mm-hmm. Are you still with him, even though you weren't born?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What about the others?
We're all here.
Mm-hmm. Jamie, how does it affect you as a soul to go through an abortion?
We're confused.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
We seem like we're stuck somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
And we can't get out.
Mm-hmm. Are you attached to anybody in particular?
Yes.
To whom? Mm-hmm. Is she willing to let you go?
She doesn't know we're there.
Ah, would you be willing to let go of her?
Yes, if my dad says so.
Okay, so let me speak with your dad. I'm going to touch his forehead. Dad, what would you like to tell your three children? Would you allow them to let go?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to tell them?
I want them to go to the light.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll see them when I get there.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't understand what I was doing.
Mm-hmm. Can you forgive yourself for that?
Yes.
Okay, let me take that from you. Let me take that from you. Just give it to me.
Okay.
So let me speak with Jamie. Jamie, your dad says that he would like to be forgiven for that. Do you accept that from him?
He's always been forgiven.
Mm-hmm. Good.
He's a good daddy.
Good. Are you ready to go to the light now, the three of you?
Yes.
All right. So I'd like to call the angels of the light to come in and circle you and take you to the light with love. Is there anything else you need?
No.
All right. Thank you. May the light of the universe accompany you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Let me speak with the higher self again.
Yes.
Has that helped?
Very emotional.
Mm-hmm. How do they feel?
They feel good, but feels hurt.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to tell him?
He'll be fine. He just loves his daughters.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
His daughters are fine.
Wonderful. Will he be able to see them?
Yes, of course.
Great. Would you do a scan on him, please? Let's take a look at his health.
He's good.
Good. Would you tell him about his pineal gland? How is it looking?
It needs work.
Okay. Can you work on that today?
Yes.
And tell him what you're using.
Using a green light.
Mm-hmm.
Pink.
Mm-hmm. Is it helping for him to drink bottled water, or would you recommend something else?
Alkaline water.
Alkaline water. Okay. So not the bottled one.
Alkaline.
Okay, good. Any particular diet to help him with the pineal gland?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Minimize eating at night, late night.
Okay. Why at night? Why does that hurt him?
Messes up his digestive system at night.
Okay.
Food turns into sugar. It messes him up.
Okay, good. He had told me, since we're talking about sugar, about the diabetes in his family. Why is the diabetes so rampant? Why has it killed so many?
Because of the thought process of his family.
Ah. So it has nothing to do with your food or diet or anything?
No.
Okay.
It's the thought behind the foods.
Okay. Is that why he hasn't been touched by it?
Yes.
Okay. What about his brothers and sisters?
His brothers and sisters are healthy.
Okay, good.
One of them are on drugs.
Mm-hmm.
So, there's an issue with him.
Mm-hmm. Can we send him some healing today?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you very much. What color is his aura?
Blue.
Blue. Does that signify anything?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Signify where he came from.
Where he came from?
Yes.
Is it serious?
Yes.
That's the blue planet?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Very good. He says that his stomach always feels funny. Why is that?
The way he eats.
Mm.
And there was a surgical procedure done when he was younger.
Mm-hmm.
That was done incorrectly.
Mm-hmm.
I will work on that to heal that.
Thank you very much, because I know that the higher self can do anything, do any healing. Can just continue doing that at night and while he sleeps.
Yes.
Thank you. Why does his heart ache so much?
Because of the relationship pains that he bears. Mm-hmm. He takes full responsibility.
Can we alleviate that today?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do I need to take anything from him?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm going to put my hand on your chest, over your heart, where it aches. And I want you to give to me all of those emotions that have been paining you for so long. Go through all of your heart. Remove all of the blockages that you've put in there. Break down all of the walls. Anything that's holding you back from having a good relationship. All of the guilt. All of the shame for not being the warrior that you came here to be. Allow your heart to be vulnerable again. Be strong for the women in your life. And tell me when all of it is removed.
Yes.
Let me take that from you. Now, what would you like to put in that heart?
Manliness.
Mm-hmm. Let's put all that manliness in there. Very good.
What else? Leadership.
Mm-hmm.
Chivalry.
Mm-hmm.
Honor.
Mm-hmm.
Respect. Nobility.
Mm-hmm.
Kindness. Joy. Patience. Thank you.
Very good. Very good. Let me speak with the higher self again.
Yes.
He had spoken to me and told me that when he was little, he always saw shadows, but he called the watchers. Who are these shadows?
Those are his ancestors.
Okay. All right. Very good. And he wanted to know who his mom sold her kids to.
Sold the kids to an entity.
To an entity. Mm-hmm. Is that entity still controlling their lives?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How can we remove that entity and cut that contract with them?
That contract would need to be discussed
mm-hmm.
with his siblings.
Okay.
So they must cut the contract.
They must cut the contract. So what would you like to tell today about how he should do this?
Bring them here.
Mm-hmm.
Go through this process with them.
Mm-hmm.
They need it badly.
Mm-hmm. Here being where?
Here, where I am here.
Mm-hmm.
This exact process.
Okay. So they need to have a session too?
Yes.
Okay. Good. And then we'll do the same thing with them.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Wonderful. He asked about the money pattern that he has. He seems to be broke at the beginning of every year. Why is that?
It's the alignment of the signs.
Hmm.
It's his natural. It's a natural occurrence.
Mm-hmm.
It's a retrograde experience.
Mm-hmm.
That he needs to understand.
So
we ask him to understand astrology.
Okay.
And when he understands astrology, he will be able to deal with this ebb and flow in his life.
Mm-hmm.
Understand that the ebbs must happen. And then the flow will come again.
Mm-hmm.
Understand that these things happen as a natural occurrence of life. There's a rhythm to life.
Mm-hmm.
And he must understand and respect that rhythm.
Does that happen with everyone?
That happens with everyone.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes you have a lot of money and sometimes you have none.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And sometimes a relationship is fun and sometimes it's not. Is this an ebb and a flow?
Mm-hmm. Why is it that the relationship suck all of his energy out?
Because he takes responsibility for everything. He takes this to heart.
Mm-hmm.
He is very hard on himself.
Mm-hmm.
Very extremely hard on himself.
Well, we just did some exercises. You think those will help with?
Yes, very much.
Mm-hmm. Good. What are the number patterns that he sees? The 1-1s, 2-2s, 3-3s? What is that all about?
He knows what those patterns are. We've showed him clearly. Mm-hmm. He asked for it, and we gave it to him.
Mm-hmm. So he knows what that is.
He knows what those patterns are.
Mm-hmm.
And please tell him to respect those patterns.
Right. I'm looking for some of his questions that he didn't want to ask. About the car crash. What did that car crash into him?
The car crash was an alignment issue.
Mm-hmm.
He was not in alignment
with
his higher self.
Okay, so you...
We need to bring him back into alignment. He's trying to go back into a religious type of dogma. And we're trying to keep him away from that. That is done in his life.
So no religion?
No.
Mm-hmm. Let's see if there's any other here that are good. Is there anything that I should have asked him? What else would you like to tell him that I didn't ask?
That she's a very good woman.
Mm-hmm.
But she has issues. Just like any other woman. But this one is very delicate. And we need to deal with her. In a very delicate manner. It might not be done in this life.
Mm-hmm.
He must go on. We will find him another.
Mm-hmm.
But he will meet her again.
Okay. Good. Good.
Is there anything else that you would like to tell him before we finish our session today?
I'd like to thank him for his sacrifices and being here. I know in his position that it's not easy. I know he's worrying about the amount of money that he's spending. But it's fine. We'll replenish that. He will always have wealth and abundance in his life. Because that's part of his contract to always have. He's always had.
Very good. Do you have anything to say for me today?
Thank you, Alba. Thank you for bringing this session to him. He really needed someone to talk to.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't really have any friends that he can talk to about this. But we are setting that up too.
Good.
You are his friend.
I'm here for him. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Welcome back. How you feeling? You did great.
It's funny as I didn't hear any noise, outside noise, until a few moments ago. That's funny.
It all came back, huh?
Yeah.
Wow. You did great. How long did it feel?
Oh, man. I don't know, I feel like it was about 30 minutes or something.
It's probably close to maybe an hour and a half. Something like that. With all the interruptions, it's probably longer. What do you remember?
I remember my skin was red.
Really red, right?
Yeah.
Like unusually red.
Yeah, like an Indian / some.
It's like a different race almost, huh?
Yeah.
It wasn't Indian race, it was like a different race.
Yeah, but.
But red.
Yeah, it was like a skin red, not like the color, like not like the crayon.
Mm-hmm.
Like a.
But it wasn't tan, it was different color. You said that a few times.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And there were also some people that looked African color, right? Almost like a...
I think we were fighting them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we... But we were fighting them, and then after that we... But the women were African.
Mm-hmm. And they were...
But my wife was very fair skinned.
Oh, really? That's interesting. Yeah. What about the children?
Children were darker, my complexion.
Mm-hmm. And you were a warrior.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And your friend, that really was a big... That really hurt you.
The reason why that hurts me is because he looked like my son.
Mm-hmm.
Like my son's son.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's why that hurt me. Mm-hmm. And I was telling my son, like, some time ago, I was like, you know, we could have been friends a long time ago because, like, me and my son were friends.
Mm-hmm.
That really hurt me. I didn't even want to go through that scene.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But it made a lot of sense why you did. I mean, that there was so much love for this man. You had such a connection with him.
Yeah.
Yeah, what about your ancestors?
That really made me... That kind of upset me. Yeah, Buchmann was funny because...
Mm-hmm.
Buchmann is part of the... the reason why they call him Buchmann is because he used to study a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So... I understand that he's always been around me because I study a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember when I first heard his name, I was like, I wonder if that's, they call him Buchmann because he studied a lot of
and
books.
He wanted you to study. That's what he was saying.
How did it feel when I brought in the light?
From which point?
From your ancestors.
Oh, yeah, the whole big light thing?
Yeah, I felt like I was going to fall off my chair.
Yeah, this whole room was like lit up.
I felt it too. I was getting white light on my face.
I'm like, man.
That was strong, wasn't it?
Yeah, and Bookman was smiling.
Yeah.
Because he was feeling it. But I was telling him, I remember trying to tell him, if he leaves, will I still have that desire to study?
Yeah.
And he was like, I'm not really going anywhere. I'm trying to get somewhere to help you.
Yeah, exactly. But that was powerful. I never realized how powerful it was, because I was kind of like in my chair spinning around, and the light was almost hurting my eyes.
Yeah, everybody kind of got sucked into the light, and I could see Bookman,
like,
because
it was like a vortex.
Yeah.
It felt like it was a vortex. Yeah. I was spinning around in it too.
Bookman was just smiling. Mm-hmm. And I was just looking at him, and I could almost see his face. Mm-hmm. And I was like, I was like, okay. And it's funny that he's the one that came forward.
Yeah.
My aunt came forward too, because she was mad.
She was
mad at me.
Ooh.
Yeah, she was kind of mad at me. Uh-huh. She was like, I keep telling you about that.
And what about Mac?
Mac was funny because
he was not about to leave at the beginning. He's like, I'm not going to tell you my name. I don't need you.
Mac came and he was smiling. And he was like, okay, I'm going to get rid of this lady right quick. And I was just watching because I wanted to see the engagement.
Uh-huh.
And plus I wanted to feel his personality.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay, that's what I've been feeling. Mm-hmm. You know, this trying to be a Mac.
Mm-hmm.
This trying to womanize. And mm-hmm. I was like, that's where that junk is coming from.
Yeah.
And
it was his influence.
Yeah.
Since you were 8.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You're going to feel almost a loss. You're going to feel like a loss, because it's like you've had him with you all this time, that sometimes you feel an emptiness after this.
I feel much lighter.
Mm-hmm.
Like my
you were carrying so many people.
Yeah, so just wonder. Like I feel lighter. Mm-hmm. I feel lighter, and I feel like I know my higher self better now.
Mm-hmm.
It's like my whole, everybody around me, or everybody in my spiritual, in the spiritual circumference where I'm the center, they're warrior-like. And they're just like, in my dreams, they don't have time for the games. Like, you know, just like, hey, careful, we telling you. You know, that these guys don't play. Like, I felt my higher self, like, it's not the one to be played with.
Yeah, yeah. And when I asked about your siblings, it's like, no, they have to go through this too.
Yeah, he didn't allow me to interfere.
Nope. It was like, that's their journey.
I told my sister that. I said, man, you might have to come here.
Uh-huh.
I wanted her to come tonight and just watch the session.
Yeah, she can't.
But some way, something happened where she couldn't.
No, and I don't permit it either.
Right. So, yeah. So
that's why.
it was a double whammy. So, but I told her, I said, she has to come here. And I was like, man, I wish I could have all my, you know, all my siblings come.
Mm-hmm. Are they all in Miami?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so it's convenient. You don't have to fly them from anywhere else.
Oh, but one, my brother.
Okay.
I would love for my brother to come.
So do you recommend this?
Yes. Highly recommend. Like, I never expected to be a red man. Like, you know, I'm thinking I'm going back to Egypt, you know, as Pharaoh or something.
Well, but man, you were a powerful warrior in that life.
I
you were a king.
Yeah, but that was a hard experience for me.
Mm-hmm.
Because that was hard.
Mm-hmm.
Because I saw my friend on there like that, and I was like, what the heck happened to me? Mm-hmm. I just turned around for a second.
And you're gone.
Why are you on the floor, not moving? I mean, dead.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, the heck? This is my fault. Because I always take things as...
Yeah, personally.
On me, right?
Yeah. Well, we took care of that.
Yeah, that was a good experience.
Is this something you want to share?
Yeah, I'll share this. I mean, it's not bad. I share it if I could have the pictures instead of me talking, to have like the picture, just like you had yours.
What pictures?
You know how you have yours, like you show the pictures, but it's not the person talking.
Oh, I can cartoon you your face so that you
can. That's fine. Yeah, that's good. Yeah.
And maybe, you know, if there's anything personal in there you want to pick out, we can.
No, just no names.
Okay.
So
Any names.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, anything. Yeah, but I think it's fine.
Excellent. Good. So let me turn the light here.
Oh, man.
Look at the time. Okay, so here we are in Miami, Florida. My name is Alba Weinman. We just had a very nice session. And if you would like to have a session of your own, please go to albaweinman.com, and we'll see you soon. Bye.